Do you ever find yourself at the end of a long day at work? You get home, you're exhausted, you throw it on your stuff, throw it on your bag, throw it on your lunch, and you get the meanest craving of your life. And right at that moment, the big internal battle begins. Should I eat this? Should I not? It's just once. I can start over again tomorrow. No, fight it. Don't do it. Use willpower. Use discipline. Don't go there. But it just so happens to be one of those days where you say, you know what? I deserve it. I need it. So you give in. It tastes great. It tastes fantastic. You feel so much better after. You plop down on the couch or right on the sofa, you feel a ton better, and then you promptly regret it. And the next day when you wake up and you still regret it, you blame it on having no willpower or not having enough discipline. Well, you might not know that many things deplete your willpower, and some of them are not things that you normally think of. But in this video, I'm going to show you how to refill that willpower gauge, that willpower tank, so you can make all the right decisions every single day to get closer to all your life and your health and your weight loss goals. Hey everyone, it's Alex, the founder of ModernHealthMonk.com here. Now, in 2007, a really interesting study was done in the Journal of Personality and Social Psychology. Now, in the study, hundreds of college students were taken to do tasks that would use their willpower. So, for example, in one group, the students would actually have to watch a video of a woman talking and a woman giving directions. But in the bottom right corner of the video, every 10 seconds, a random word would pop up, and they would be told not to concentrate on the word. So imagine watching a video, you're trying to stay focused, and the researcher tells you, whatever you do, do not focus on the word in the bottom. But every 10 seconds, a word would be popping up constantly, constantly in your face, constantly interrupting your attention. Now, in the other group, there was no task that required willpower, so there was no willpower used in the process. And what the researchers did was, before and after the experiment, they measured the glucose used by the body, and in particular, the brain. So again, remember, the participants were either forced to do a willpower-using task and then do something, or something that did not use their willpower and then do the same task. Now, in between tasks, one group was given Kool-Aid or lemonade filled with sugar, so with glucose, quick absorbing energy, but the other group was given Splenda, in other words, a buzzkill, a total placebo for the experiment. Now, what's interesting is that the placebo group that did not get the sugar actually committed twice as many errors in the process and in the experiment. Now, the researchers eventually concluded that willpower is like a mental muscle, and it does not regenerate itself very quickly. But there was another experiment done on the nutrition and willpower link that showed something even scarier. The second study was done by the Stanford School of Business on the Israeli parole system. Now, in this study, researchers analyzed 1,112 parole hearings, and they wanted to see if there was any link between the willpower or the mental state of the judges, the people actually, you know, the jury deciding the fate of these people in the parole system, and the outcome of the people, of the parolees. Now, it's important to remember that this is actually a very mentally tasking system. So the judges are only given 6 minutes for each hearing, and they have to do something between 50 and 40 of them a day, and they only have 2 breaks in a day for lunch and for a snack. So here's where it gets really interesting. After each break, and in the morning, so first thing in the morning and after each of the breaks, the parolee chances of being released were up to 60%. But by the end of the block, so in other words, after the judge had been looking at these things for 3 hours and 4 hours, and the break was coming up, the chances dropped to near zero every single time. So in other words, as these judges got more taxed, more tired, more glucose deficient, right, as they got hungrier, more mentally worn out, as the willpower was more exhausted, they ended up just going back to their default setting, which was no. So in this picture here, you can see at the top here, at the beginning of the day, where the energy is fresh, everybody's, you know, refreshed, they're ready to go, there's a very high chance of getting off, in other words. But look at further down the line, a few hours down the line, your chances of being released are not very good. They're very close to zero, and it's a very strong correlation, because look at the lunch break now. You see in the middle here in the lunch break? Go to the top. You see the almost 60%? It follows the exact same curve, going down to near zero as they get more tired, more worn out, and their willpower is more taxed and exhausted. And the same thing happens at the end of the day. So just like in the sweetened drink experiment, in the first one I showed you, where they were given a sweetened lemonade or one without sweetener, in other words, glucose or no glucose, these judges were actually making worse decisions, or in other words, default decisions, without thinking about them, once they became tired, mentally exhausted, and their willpower was just depleted. All right, so what does this actually mean for you, though? How can you apply this kind of stuff to your life? Do you just need to be more disciplined and use more willpower? No, I'm totally against this kind of stuff. This is not the secret to success. The secret to success is habits, tiny habits, done daily. So what does this actually apply to you for? There are 4 ways in particular this applies to you. But the bottom line is that overall, self-control partially relies on glucose, so whether or not you've eaten and what you have eaten. But let's talk about those 4 things now. Number one, your hardest tasks you should set for the morning. In the morning, you typically have the highest willpower, your brain is refreshed, glucose stores are pretty good, even though you've been fasting overnight. You're refreshed, you're ready to go. You're more likely to make smart decisions because you can think, you have clarity, you're not exhausted by the day yet. So whatever is hard for you, whether that's exercise, some new thing you're trying to do, try to do it before your day, before the long day, which is why most successful people in history have some kind of smart morning routine. So they wake up, they do the most important task first while they're fresh, and then do the rest of the stuff throughout the day or at the end of the day when they're more tired. Number two, make nighttime a no-brainer. So many people that I consult for, so many of my clients and students, they get frustrated because they get home from a long day of work, willpower has been depleted, they're tired, they're cranky, and guess what happens? They make a bad food decision. They go out and they get Chinese food and they drink two or three beers or two or three glasses of wine, and then they regret it, or they repeat it over and over and over for months. And that's just because of poor planning. If you know that at the end of the day you're going to be exhausted, your willpower stores are going to be depleted, you should be saving that for easy stuff. So either have a meal pre-made, have a frozen healthy pizza if that's what it takes, have a pre-made meal, have someone else make a meal, figure out how to set the end of the day to make it easy to make the right decisions. Number three, do you have an interview or some kind of exam or test? Make sure you eat before. And specifically, you want to be eating protein and complex carbs because complex carbs have the fiber to buffer the energy release and the glucose, so it's more stable release energy, more stable release sugar. It's going to keep you fuller longer as well. So if you have something coming up the next hour, an interview or some kind of exam, if you can't have brown rice and chicken, have a banana, have fruit. Eat something that's quickly absorbed glucose and fructose for your body so that it can get that kind of brain energy going quickly. And the fourth is simple. Something I recommend in all my programs, don't go hungry. Don't let yourself go hungry. It's like that Snickers commercial, you know, where they're all, you're not yourself when you get hungry, right? You get all cranky, you get all depressed, you get frustrated. Just eat more regularly because that's going to help you maintain self-control by having those complex carbs, the brown rice, right? The whole grains, if you're okay with that, the proteins. Eat regularly. You shouldn't be letting yourself get starving throughout the day. And again, that also influences your blood sugar, which first of all influences your willpower, but also influences cravings as well. So make sure you're eating regularly and the kind of complex carbs and proteins that keep you fuller longer and give you that stable energy. All right, so that's it for today. Please leave a comment below before you go anywhere and tell me what's one simple habit you could do today to apply in your daily life to get you closer to your health and your weight loss and your happiness goals. That's all for now. Take care and I'll see you soon.